Rocky, we've all been there. That time of the day when your energy levels just tank.
It's happening to me right now on live television. So before we reach for the caffeine, we've got some natural options to consider. Our registered dietitian, Lisa Redzolanik, is here. We're talking about fatigue-fighting foods.
That's right. Yes. And we naturally go to caffeine when we need that bump, right? Yeah. So let's talk about things we can do that aren't going to stress out our adrenals, which are our organs that we need to handle stress.
And that's what caffeine
does? Coffee will do that. It stresses out your adrenals. So eventually it's like beating a dead horse, and those adrenals don't respond to stress well, and you're kind of in this vicious cycle.
Okay.
So imagine if you didn't drink anything all day long.
Anything?
Anything. You didn't drink anything all day long.
What? All right.
Well, you wouldn't want to do that, but that's what happens when we sleep. So the first tip is when you get up in the morning, start your day with 2 glasses of water. A large glass of water will do wonders to get your system rolling and going. So
just whereas most people have coffee right out of the bed.
Right, and that's a diuretic. It makes you more dehydrated.
Right.
So a large glass of water in the morning, just a 1.5% reduction in your water volume will lead to
Now you brought a lemon here. Do we want to put a lemon in too?
You can. Lemon is great because it actually helps you absorb the water into your cells.
Okay.
But if you just want to do plain water, that's cool too. So start with water. Then the next thing I want to talk about is a superfood we're hearing more and more about, chia seeds. So chia seeds are just that. They're a seed. You can find them, if you get close up, you can find them in a seed form, and they just look just like that. They're a little seed. Or you can get them in a ground form. So basically it's the chia seed ground up, and it's more powdery. Okay? So the deal with the chia seeds are 1 tablespoon packs 5 grams of fiber, which helps us feel fuller and can help regulate our blood sugar, so we're not having those spikes.
And what do you put that tablespoon in?
You could put that in a smoothie, you could put it in oatmeal, you could put it in a chia seed pudding.
Does it have a taste?
It's pretty tasteless, but I will tell you, I prefer more of the ground chia seed when I'm using it, because the ground blends more easy versus the seeds. It's like you feel the little seeds in there.
But is it like, so is it like flaxseed in the fact that you have to grind it to get benefit?
No. No, that's a good question, Nicole. This one you don't have to grind, but it's more of how you like the taste of it.
And you're right. It really has no distinctive taste whatsoever, so it would blend into things.
It would blend into things, and it's great because it's got a good dose of B vitamins, which help fight fatigue.
Okay.
So let's talk about tangible thing. What can we do in the morning to get the day off started with some energy? Well, I'm going to talk to you today about an energy boosting shake.
Okay.
So we have in here about 1.5 cups of nut milk. You can use whatever milk you want to use, almond, cashew, whatever milk you're using. And we're going to use 1 tablespoon of ground flaxseed.
Okay.
So the ground flaxseed, again, it blends better. So I'm going to put that tablespoon of ground flaxseed.
Okay.
Again, be vitamins, fiber, protein to help your energy stay stable.
Okay.
Then we're going to add 1/2 cup of frozen blueberries.
Okay.
These have melted a little bit on stage here on the set. But we're going to put that half a cup of blueberries. Blueberries have antioxidants in them that fight stress. Free radicals. Free radicals combat our fatigue. Blueberries can fight that. Then the strange ingredient here we're going to use is 1/2 or whole green banana.
Why green banana?
Sweet. So green bananas actually are kind of tasteless because the starch isn't developed yet. So what a green banana is it's a resistant starch. So what that means is we humans can't digest it, but the bacteria in our gut can. And so these are called prebiotics. They're food for the healthy gut bacteria. If we feed the gut healthy gut bacteria, science has shown it helps boost our mood.
And so you buy them green,
you
peel them
green,
and freeze them
so you just take a knife, you peel them out of there, because you really can't peel a green banana.
Right.
It's not ripe, right? No carbon here, because it's not a ripe banana, okay?
Really?
And it does really taste like anything. So get them home, peel them. Put them in a Ziploc bag and freeze them.
Right.
Then when you need them in the morning, you just take your frozen banana and you put it in there, okay?
Nice.
Then we're going to move on to maca powder, okay? Maca, you're going to hear a lot more coming about maca powder. You're going to see it in smoothies. You're going to see it in energy drinks, energy bars, baked goods. What maca is it's a root vegetable from Peru, and it's a natural adaptogen that helps you deal with all forms of stress. It also helps balance your hormones and promote hormone balance.
Mm.
So starting with 1 teaspoon a day of this, this stuff is pretty powerful, so don't, you know, load up on this stuff too much.
Okay.
And Nicole, I will tell you that this has had a lot of research related to stamina, mood, and energy, but there has been no research for pregnant or nursing women.
No,
so just be mindful
that
of that.
Right, so let's move, because I don't want to miss this. So
and then we got a tablespoon of MCT oil. This is a type of oil that burns it burns really efficiently.
Okay.
So it's a type of oil that we can use that we burn really well and quickly is to help boost our energy. We're going to put a dollop of our famous almond butter in there. If you want to use peanut butter, you could.
Okay.
But a tablespoon or two of that in there.
Okay, it should be natural or peanut butter if you do it.
Yep, so that's just ground almonds is in there, and that almond butter. And then you pop this puppy on your blender, and let's get some power.
That's a good one. That's right in there.
Yep. And then there you go. So you can blend it a little bit more, but just to give you the, you know, lowdown.
Now there's a banana in there, so you're not going to taste it.
Yeah, she won't like that.
Can I?
Yep, absolutely.
Cool.
So there you go.
And we've got this recipe on our website as well, and your website, more ideas as well.
Yep, your tasty life you can go to is the energy boosting shake.
Oh my gosh.
She's surprised.
Yeah, and I explain more about those ingredients on the website. So go ahead and check it out.
It's interesting.
Yeah, okay.
I am surprised because I didn't see junk, I didn't see sugar, I didn't see anything.
And you like it.
The maca tastes a little bit like malt. It makes it taste a little malty,
like
a shake.
Good malt.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm going to be chilled and healthy.
And energized. No fatigue today.
Energized on this break. We'll be right back.